Bless everybody and good morning. Okay, so we have Ecclesiastes 3, 1 and 8. Anytime that we pray, you always have to have a prayer point because you don't have a focus, and that's how you start prayer. So let's see, who wants to read Ecclesiastes 3, at least 3 verses, or maybe all of them. It's chapter 3, 1 through 8. If not, let me know and I'll read it. While you're looking, I'll just recap on the information that I posted in the group chat. This is the third day, and you know, 3 means that you seal something. 1, 2, 3. 3 days there was a resurrection. 3 equals the lines of the Trinity, and 3 is a community where 2 or 3 of us is gathered. It's a significant number because after 2 people come together, the next one makes 3. It could be in family or partnerships or relationships. And 3 gives an understanding of the ability to have a negotiator there, because 2 people don't always agree on the same thing. So where 3 of us are gathered, right? All right, so during the fall, nature begins to disappear. And that means that the grass and the leaves start doing a thing. Oxygen levels are changed. That's why the leaves change colors. The leaves turn green to red because they're starting to lose the oxygen that they had. What this is telling us is time to prepare for winter. And the emphasis on this is also getting us aligned with prayer as a spiritual practice to understand that nature actually shows us how to live properly. And so it needs rest. We need rest, right? The equinox. And, okay. So
all right.
Okay, you got it. Okay.
To everything, there is a season and a time. To every purpose under the heaven, a time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to get and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to keep silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time to war and a time of peace.
Okay, so all of that is the opposite of something that maybe we've done and, you know, we've been a part of. The focus there is bringing balance to ourselves and how we present ourselves innately, which will turn into our external presentation. So a time to be silent and a time to talk. You could have been born silenced, but the time is coming to speak. Some of the talkers had to learn. They were talking when they came out the womb, so they learn how to be silent. All of this here is a king that's given wisdom in a book. That's natural. It's a natural context, but it is reconditioned into the mind and body for each individual as they practice what they need to get stronger in. So when we look at the time that we're in, I know that a lot of people have been emotional. They feel the imbalance of the season. The season is bringing us into thought, which is a good thing. And also feeling is good because feeling is the blessing. If you feel bad, then you have the power to change your feelings. And there's a practice that you can use. That means that you're reconditioning yourself, period. Not to be who you used to and allow your undisciplined behavior to continue. And I'm just praying, because this is something that we're looking at while, you know, many are sitting and resting. Some people feel like, well, I don't like the way that that feels. But as we're discussing and praying, you know, the spiritual realms already open up for us to begin to receive what we need. And we receive by faith the change. Also by constructive criticism, we criticize ourselves into structuring ourselves for the better. If someone criticizes us, it may not be true. The best person to be honest with me is myself. Whatever changes I need to make them for me. It's not for others to love me and to see me. It's for me to be who I truly am at this moment in time and even into the future so that I can grow even more. You can see the beauty that you want in your life, but you have to resist looking at the external. For some time, the inner beauty has to become more dominant. You know, here in the scriptures become alive to us when we see a man contemplating to everything there is a season. That means that what we're going through at this time is not permanent. It too shall pass. And in the permanence of life where we have been taught that it is permanent, what we see happening is, as we awaken, is our conditioning had become like a brick, solid to believe there's no other way than what I'm experiencing now. It's always going to be like this. And that's not true, because to everything there is a change. The thing about this change that we're going through is acceptance. Acceptance that it was this and acceptance that it can be that. But the acceptance is also in practicing my belief system as I'm changing it from what it used to be. And your belief system is not just based on the tradition of religion. It's based on how you decondition and recondition. Because every morning you get up, you may have practiced what you were taught. But you begin to look at, okay, does that work for me in this time and season of my life? And if it doesn't, then you release it because it may not feel like it's healthy for you. The thing, the people, the places, that's one thing. But the dismantling of self and reconstructing self is a part of balance. You can't get balance without tearing down the old. And it's not a physical thing, it's within. What you all are doing is a thing that is time changers. Yeah. Season changing. You're going into the season changing to become a part of season. Not to work against the force of life, but to work with the force of life. I heard many people talk about the forces of nature, but they didn't talk about it the way that I see it now. In this chapter, it teaches you. because the forces of nature means that a lot of people are sick. They don't have what they need because they didn't pay attention to nature. All of the Bible that we have teaches about nature, but the fine line was looked over. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for bringing us back into divine order. Thank you for your healing. Thank you for your power. Thank you for the pleasures of life. Thank you for our ability to accept the things that we can change, and those things that we cannot, we release them to you. Thank you for the pure in heart. Thank you for the playfulness. Thank you that life is lighter now as we release things that we have no control over. When we learn that there's control and no control. On the wheel of life, there is control and uncontrolled. We learn through you and the prayers of the righteous that we're able to come into discipline of ourselves, master ourselves, and become controlled in situations through the power of the Most High within. We give you praise and we bless you for our families and our children. Thank you for the ability to stand in a season and time where there's uncertainty. But through you, we know that there's a certainty and we stay in your presence. And we look to the hills from which cometh our help. No other help do we know. Thank you that like a tree planted by the rivers of the water, we shall not move. Thank you for the nourishment of the water. Thank you for the air, clean air. Thank you for the fire of life, firing us up, giving us the ability to go forward with your focus to do the things that you've given us to do. Thank you that the universe supports us. Thank you that we can change our attitude at the flick of a moment. When we're feeling out of sorts, we come into sorts by turning within. Thank you that we are connected at all times through you. As we look at nature, we see how nature is cooperating with you. We also see nature uncooperative at times, but we learn from nature and the life force how to move and how to live from within. Thank you for the peace that passes all understanding is not outside of us. But if my emotions begin to rock back and forth, I can come in and speak to the emotions and the winds within myself and find peace. What is blown away or rocked away, we release it and we let it go. Thank you in this season and time for new levels, new wisdom, new understanding. Thank you for taking us higher as we cooperate with you, evolving, remembering things from the past that we need, even ancestral remembrance that's going to get us through the circumstances and time, reminding us of how to plant and seed and how to save the harvest financially, mentally, and physically concerning our houses in the days to come. Thank you for showing us the way on how to gather what we need for the days to come. Because the world is changing, you know, God, and we need instruction. We thank you for the instruction so that our homes and our lives will be balanced, that we are covered by the blood of Jesus. And as you show us, we go deeper and deeper into you to understand how to take care of ourselves, our families, and the seasons to come. The connections that we need, let them be vital and strong. The connections to people, communities that are of help services, let them be strong and vital in Jesus' name. We thank you that the universe supports us in all of our endeavors. And as we look at the things that we need to do together in you, we find that some of the things we had worried about are menial. We thank you that anxiety and worry is not our lot. We thank you that like a river that flows, we're flowing in the river of life. We're flowing in the river of life. Thank you that we can even see the beauty of the river of life. Thank you that we can see the petals of the rocks flowing, how they're shaped through the water. We thank you for new vision connected to nature. It's going to get us to another level of understanding, breaking the cycle of this material structure that we have been connected to, that through the connection of nature, we can do all things. We can truly do all things because we find our peace, our laughter, our happiness, reconnecting. The flowers are blooming, reconnecting. Health and healing, reconnecting with things that are growing, life, pure life, appreciating life, appreciating the breath and the lifeline. We thank you for this morning. Thank you for those that have come in and that they are a part of this. Thank you for the blessing of the Lord that maketh rich and it adds no sorrow. For we're blessed in the city, we're blessed in the field, we're blessed coming and going. We thank you for traveling mercies as we go out and start our day. And we thank you for your healing and your power again in Jesus' name, your uplifting. Thank you that we can pray under this new moon energy and know that all is well. Whatever imbalances that we've had in our lives, our families, down through the generations, that you're healing it. Justice is coming through our works to justify situations from the spiritual realm. Thank you that we don't have to fight for anything, that you've already done it. We thank you for the blood of Jesus. We thank you for the healing power, for love and mercy and peace. And it is so, and it is so. Amen and amen.
Amen.
All right. Are you going to pull a card now this morning?
Sure. One sec.
Blessed people, bless them. Bless them, bless them, bless us all. Bless, Lord. Bless your communities, your cities, your states. Thank you for healing. Thank you for healing. Communities covering children in the Jesus name, covering the children, universal mother, father, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. We thank you and we praise you, we bless you, that you have our backs. Thank you for focus, thank you for laser focus, to see the truth in people and through people, to bless them and keep going. Thank you. For freedom from hurt and pain, doubt and worry. Thank you. In Jesus' name. Thank you for the blessings. Thank you for the healing. Thank you for the love. Thank you for the peace, the joy. Thank you for happiness. Yeah. Amen.
All right, 1 second.
Thank you, angels. Angels here. Thank you for the angels. Thank you.
All right, so I pulled a card, but I cannot find the book. Mm-hmm. So I will let me come back. The card is doubt.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And as soon as I find the book, I'll post the meaning. But it says, I release the need to know all the answers. So like I said, as soon as I find the book that goes with this.
Okay, so the opposite of doubt also is certainty. So if anyone had any doubts, then they're going to practice certainty and confidence, which is a solar plexus area. Confidence. Heart is coming into the heart. Doubt is an imbalance to find the truth of what's really there. And so once she sends that, but I wanted to add that because you're always going to look to the opposite of something that doesn't set well in order to change it, because you can't plant a new harvest without releasing that. And I want to add also, while Nye is walking around, if you had any dreams, you want to add that. I can turn off the video at this point because people might be having some strange dreams.
I've been having dreams.